Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls. You may notice, maybe not right now, but as I pan the camera around, whoa, we are in Anor Londo, when we ended the last video at Firelink Shrine. Wanted to do something a little bit different today, and actually show off some of the PvP. You can't do PvP after the game ends, and since I only have optional areas and the final boss left, figured there's no better time than now to show off some PvP, so I'm going to an area which is kind of a PvP hotbed, and hopefully we'll be able to get some action there. I'll edit the video down just to show my invasions. Don't expect this to be like, oh my god, greatest hits invasions, like non-stop kills and hilarity. It's just going to be standard invasions for people who are not really familiar with the PvP. I'm also planning on talking a little bit about the covenants that are related to player versus player, and if you're familiar with that, then this might seem like kind of a, you know, we're rehashing old territory, but hopefully there's something interesting for everybody involved. I'm going to put my Silver Knight armor back on. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put my Channeler set back on, because I feel like that strikes fear into the heart of everybody you come across. It's not my Channeler's helm. There it is. All right, so I'm dressed as those motherfuckers who, like, hunt you down and shoot soul arrows at you. And what I'm trying to do right now is just go back to the bonfire that where we met Solaire, and he hinted that he probably wanted our phallus inside of his body. Let's see what this message says. Here, congratulations! The fact that I don't see a lot of messages kind of worries me. It is really early here. Well, kind of early. It's like 11 a.m. on a Monday. And you know, Dark Souls, mature game for mature audiences, so a lot of the people that play this game primarily are probably at work, which is fine. We'll try to hopefully get some action. Now remember, I'm a member of the Darkwraith, so we're going to be using an item called the Cracked Red Eye Orb to invade. You can also use a regular Red Eye Orb, but in order to get that, you need to give 10 humanity to Darkstalker Katha. I haven't done that yet, but, you know, by the end of this video, we could presumably have 10 humanity. I could just pop. I have, like, 24 humanity on me right now. I could just pop 6 right now and go see him. But it doesn't really matter. The invasions work basically the same way, either way. Darkwraiths, as a general rule with Cracked Red Eye Orbs, invade up. So, essentially, what am I? I'm like level 53? Level 50. So anybody that's above level 50, fair game for invasions as long as they're human. If you're hollow, you cannot be invaded. So first thing we're gonna do is just murder these guys to get back to the bonfire. Try not to get killed because it's a fucking long way back. Using Quaalog's Fury Sword, and I believe my Pyromancer Flame is the other weapon that I have equipped to my right-hand slot. We're going to come down here and go to the bonfire, and then the one other thing you need to know about invasions is that, oh, forgot about this guy. You do need to be human to invade as well, but I'll talk a little bit about the requirements and the bonuses and the penalties for invasions once I actually get to this bonfire. Rest, reverse humanity, and then we get started on our glorious adventure of PvPing here. So there's some more messages. This is a pretty popular area. Alright, rest of the bonfire, reverse hollowing. Now, we can't be invaded here because we've already defeated the area boss. So I don't have to worry about turning human and then getting invaded while I'm trying to invade. The other thing we're going to do is equip our cracked red eye orb. 31 of those, goddamn. On our quick bar. And then we're going to use one. And this will essentially search for other players that are higher level than me. In this area who are human right now, and I will be able to invade them. If there's already another invader in their world, I'm pretty sure I can't actually rejoin. I've got Dark Hand equipped, actually. I should switch that for Pyromancy Flame for sure. That could actually get me in some trouble. And then we're just going to wait, essentially, until we actually get some invasions going on here. Where is my Pyromancy Flame? Oh, that is not the right button. We'll just... Sometimes I like the spamits, just to see... Seems like it makes it a little bit faster, but I might be talking out of my ass. And then essentially, while you're doing this, just walk around. Farm these guys, pick up the items that they drop, get some extra souls. You can see I have 150-something thousand right now. Although I believe that's as many as I had at the end of the last video. Good opportunity to practice your parrying and riposting. If you are not very good at that, because these guys really telegraph their attacks, and it's an easy way to kill them. So within the next minute or two, we should... find our invasion target. Sometimes it'll say invasion failed, but invasions seem to work a hell of a lot more often then the summoning works, at least for me, and at least anecdotally, and at least on this character. With other characters, when I'm not recording, no fucking problems, right? As usual. But on this character, things are a little bit finicky, unfortunately. Oh, here we go, we got an invasion, so I'm gonna run away from this guy. Because he's an asshole. And he's gonna want us dead. And then we'll have a little bit of a loading screen, and then we'll enter the world, and I can talk about what we're gonna be dealing with. And I'll do some editing a little bit later once we get into, like, Invasions 2, Invasions 3. Because you don't need to see all of this happening every single time. So we've invaded Archobo here. And I'm going to try to find him. So it's a little bit like a cat and mouse game at this point. I saw his health bar somewhere over here. Somewhere right there. Archobo, are you in here? He died? What happened, Archobo? Alright, well, every time you win an invasion, and you win an invasion by destroying the host, whether you kill him or an enemy kills him, you get one loose humanity, which goes up in your top left there. You can see I have four now. I used to have four, but then I took an arrow to the- Fuck you! No. I used to have four, but then I used one to reverse hollowing. So I went down to three, now I'm back up to four. You also get a certain amount of souls, not very much, usually in the vein of like 1 to 2,000, based on how high their level is relative to yours. Anyway, one thing I want to say is if you die as a Red Phantom, you don't lose Oh, we're invading again! Get out of here! This is what I mean, like, invasions are so much fun because they happen so much more frequently than summonings. Hopefully that's our Chobo again. I can basically send him a message like, yo dude, what the fuck? A lot of people are scared of PvP, so they kind of hide, which is annoying when you're trying to find them. It's a mixed bag, you know, sometimes you get douchebags who just hide or, like, troll you. Alright, summoning Phantom, so I know that means he's in one of two places, most likely. He's probably in the bonfire room, or he's in the room of Solaire. Ninja Coke 69. Oh god, there he is! Okay. I like to be nice and bow at the start of my battles, which usually gets me backstabbed, like this guy's gonna do right here. But look at that, you can tell he's weak, it did like no damage to me. So this motherfucker is gonna pay now. Oh, you got a Life Hunt Scythe? Big fucking deal. That's not even a Life Hunt Scythe, is it? Let's try some Pyromancy. Oh god, there's a second Phantom! This is bad for business, man. Alright, now here's a strategy you can use as a Dark Phantom. Run. Running is really good. I was hoping that shortcut was opened. Ignore me. And if you're not gonna run, well, try to run into some enemies. Because they can help you out. Of course he's killed the Silver Knight in here. The enemies can't hurt you, but they do hurt, them, which is good. So we're gonna focus on the host here. Now, the host can heal, Red Phantoms cannot heal. So we have to be kind of careful. And this is not good combat right here. He's gonna try to heal. Bad move. Oh god, I got backstabbed! This is a damn shame. Oh, they are gonna gang rape me here. The host is using a weapon that actually causes me to get bleed. What is that? Oh, I've never seen that attack before. That was really cool. Luckily I can just block it. Alright, now I can actually heal. That was a bit of a misnomer. I can use humanity to heal, and obviously humanity heals you fully. Normally kind of a dick move to do. I was thinking about doing it here just to demonstrate, but I'm probably gonna die anyway, so why waste the humanity, right? Now these guys are almost certainly gonna gang rape me. A lot of 2v1s and 3v1s in player versus player combat. When you're the Phantom, anyway. And the reason for this is that obviously, people summon phantoms for help. I'm gonna try to run away and maybe I can be a bitch, heal up, and start dragging these guys into some enemies. Kind of a dick move, but you know, as a phantom, I feel like play fair, but also win at any cost. Let's Estus up just for fun. Or, not Estus up, we'll use a humanity. I'll probably lose it, but again, you don't lose your humanity if you die as a black phantom. You actually, you keep it on your bloodstain. You have to go find it, though. Alright, host, you should not have come up here by yourself. That's, I thought I was gonna get backstabbed for fucking sure. Host is gonna run away, probably Estus up. A lot of the time, it's basically just fighting the host until he uses all 10 Estus. But it's kind of fun, it's like a war of attrition. Oh, that host. That host! He's wasting his stamina. If I get a backstab, I could kill him! He's so close! I got him! No, I just staggered in the backstab! Oh god, I hit my microphone's pop filter! So many things going on at once. This host is not great, but in this 2v1, he's keeping me on my toes. This has been a fun invasion so far. I'm probably going to die. Almost certainly going to die, in fact, but it's fun nonetheless. Could pop another humanity, but, you know, let's... Don't pull out your bow, you dickhole. This might actually be better for us. We can probably spam the host while he tries to shoot us with arrows. All right, he's wised up and realized that that was a horrible idea. And there could be... Oh, God, they've cleared out, like, all the enemies in here. I'm fucked. This is how I die. Yep. That was fun, though. That was really good. The guy's still a total bitch for not bowing back to me. But, you know, shit happens. I understand this. The one thing that's worth talking about is a lot of people get bent out of shape when it comes to PvP etiquette. Particularly, there's two things that are bad about the PvP, and I'll admit this. One of them is that there's a huge contingent of people called twinks, and, you know, a lot of people are offended by that name. First, before I get into that, let me demonstrate the bloodstain mechanic. So essentially, we're just going to go back to where we invaded. You can see I'm still human, so we don't lose humanity when we die. So where I got called up for that invasion is where my bloodstain will be. I'll pick that up, I'll have all of my humanity and my souls back. So there's really no risk to invading as long as your bloodstain's in a spot that's easy to get. You literally lose nothing. We're gonna use another cracked red eye orb here. So yeah, there's people called twinks, and essentially what these people do, remember Darkwraiths invade up. What they will do is stay at a super low level and not beat some of the early game bosses. Hey, is that true? That might not be true. They'll stay at a super low level and go through the game or use a glitch, which I'm not going to talk about so much because I'm actually not familiar with it, to get endgame equipment. And then they will just invade new players and essentially, like, with equipment like I have right now, just totally fuck their days up. So we're using, like, a Quaalog's Fury Sword +4 and a heavy set of armor, a good stability shield, against someone who's wearing, like, the default equipment and using, like, Scimitar +2, like I was. For example, the Undead Parish is a big area for quote-unquote twinking. And that sucks. I don't think people should do that, and I understand why people are mad at Darkwraiths when they do that. But then there's also Darkwraiths who get mad. Sorry, just adjusting my pop filter here. When people do, when Darkwraiths invade, and then it's like a 3v1, which is also total bullshit for Darkwraiths to get mad at, because you're invading their world. You put yourself in their mindset. Whenever I get invaded, I'm like, oh fuck, I'm just trying to beat the game here, and this guy's trying to fuck my shit up. One second. Making sure my poor old computer doesn't fall asleep. Did I just see Phantom Knight Solaire summoned at the bottom of the screen? If so, I know where they are. PJ Drizzt. Not in here. I think I know where he is. The hunting phase is like my least favorite phase in the whole fucking game. It takes 100 years to find them sometimes, especially if they hide. But Anor Londo is actually a really good area because you can find them. But anyway, as far as I'm concerned, when I invade, I like to have a little bit of respect. Like, I'll usually let the host heal a little bit. Unless it's like a super close battle and I know I'm going to die. 100% for sure. What was I even talking about? I think it's invaders should have a little bit of respect and understand that you are, like, invading their game and you could really ruin their shit. Like, I could kill this guy. That could be his last humanity that he's losing and he won't be able to beat Ornstein and Smough now, which kind of sucks, but that's also Dark Souls in a nutshell, essentially, isn't it? But hosts win by any fucking means necessary, as far as I'm concerned. This is not mutual consenting PvP. This is like, ah, God. That's another mechanic that I should point out, is that when they go fight the boss, you are banished to your own world. It doesn't happen that often. I'm surprised that it came up here. It is not consenting, you know, loving PvP. If you want to do that, you can use the red sign soapstone, which we'll pick up in the painted world whenever we choose to do that. This is like PvP rape, essentially. So you gotta have some understanding when people are like, look at how fast invasions happen, I love it. You gotta have some understanding when people are, you know, spamming spells at you and you are the invader, or they're summoning three people to fight. And honestly, those are some of the best wins, when you have like three phantoms and you actually manage to succeed. It's rare, and that's what makes it so special. Now hopefully we'll get another PvP opportunity here. Nippon Natanamanu. That wasn't... Oh god! He's got a Demon Great Axe and Smough's armor. Well, Smough's leggings anyway. Alright, this guy has like strong equipment and it looks like he knows what he's doing, which means I'll probably die and I'm definitely not gonna bow. I'm guessing he's Japanese, based on his name, which is cool. There's a strong Japanese community in this game. Yeah, but I'm playing this on the Xbox 360, so let's be honest, probably not Japanese. Oh, I thought I was going to be able to get a good backstab off there. He's got a lot of health, too. You can see I did 80 damage, took off almost nothing. That's the thing. A lot of PvP ends up just being circling for backstabs. I try to avoid that as much as possible. But, you know, I fell victim to that, too. Certainly. It's tempting, because it does so much damage. I wish this guy would back off for a second. I actually want to use my Lightning Uchi Katana. Oh, my God! That was probably a bad idea on his part. But you can see 275 damage did, like, almost nothing to him. So I'm almost certainly going to die. Oh, I didn't expect to get the chain backstab there. This is kind of cheap, but oh well. It works for now. Remember, this guy can heal, too. He probably has, like, Estus plus 6. He may also have super lag or just suck at the game because, you know, as much as spamming backstabs is kind of a cheap tactic. Oh, well, he got me anyway. It's also pretty easy to avoid. Demon Great Axe is okay, easy badass. Spamming backstabs is kind of a cheesy tactic, but it's also really easy to avoid if you have any skill. That guy didn't seem like a particularly good fighter. I mean, all respect to him, he definitely beat me, but he definitely had me outmatched when it comes to equipment. Which is the way that invasion should go, you know? You should kind of be, I don't want to say you're the underdog when you're invading, because you definitely have a psychological advantage, just forcing your way into their world. But, you know, you're invading up. So you could be invading someone who has just, like, not killed the area boss, but use something called the Bottomless Boss Glitch to get a lot of endgame equipment. Don't Google that if you want to have a good Dark Souls experience. Alright, another invasion. Maybe I actually won't have to do any editing here. Now, a lot of people have asked, like, Northern, why don't you do a video that shows off summoning? Doing a video that shows off invading, super easy. Oh, I can already see this guy. Doing a video that shows off summoning, hard as hell, because sometimes it takes half an hour between summons. Gonna check for phantoms in here. Nope. I definitely just saw this guy, like, over here somewhere. I'm pretty sure he's probably running. Oh, God! So the host has run away, I think. Just nerfed, like, all my stamina there. I would love to get out of this and fight a little bit more in the open. Why is this guy so scared? Press shield, halberd, strong stability. One thing that's kind of unreliable in PvP is, oh, that hurts. Both of us. Is, parrying. I've seen people do it online, but it's rare because the latency issues are obviously a problem. So if we kill this phantom, we get some souls. More importantly, the phantom dies, so we actually have a better chance against the host, which is nice. I'm just gonna tank it. I'll use a humanity to heal if necessary. Sorry, buddy. It sucks to be a summoned phantom and then the host just abandons you. Alright, so that guy's dead. Sorry, Robot Penguin 16. Oh, God! Alright, this is what I mean about being respectful. We'll bow to him, and if he doesn't do anything, he might be turning off his Xbox. A lot of people just disconnect or, like, go back to the dashboard when there's an invader. Dude, I hate to do this, but I'm recording a video. I can't just let you live. We'll give it a second. Let's switch to our Uchi Katana. I prefer this weapon for PvP. There we go. Okay, he's back. Awesome. Just tried to scare him a little bit there. Right, he's got an eagle shield, which is a good shield for stability. He's just gonna hack like crazy, which is something that a lot of new players do. Oh god, the backstab got me. He might actually kill me. He's got a lot of bleed on that sword, too. I'm not sure what that is. That might be the Iado. Iado? I don't know. Bleed meter is almost filled up. He's probably gonna heal. Oh no, he's switching to pyro. I don't know what that was, actually. Oh god, what is that? What? He's losing health at a rapid rate. Run away! Draw him into the Silver Knight. Yeah, you like this? Pretty cheap tactic, isn't it? Alright, this has been a decent fight so far. I thought this guy sucked. He actually seems okay. Pyromancy's super easy to dodge in PvP. But the more I keep him on his toes, apparently the more health he's losing. I wish I could, like, fake throw some pyromancy at him. Instead, we'll just continue the song and dance. Feels good, man. How's that damage treating you? War of attrition, man. Should have tried to bait him into thinking I was out of pyromancy. There we go. Put my sword back out again. Where are you going? He's probably healing again. Not sure if that did anything. All right, come back here and fight me like a man, says the guy who ran away and is now going to pop a humanity. I don't know if I'm the classiest PvP fighter. Things I do might be cheesy, but I like it. I try to be respectful anyway, let's put it that way. This guy's got a cool weapon. I don't know what it is, but it's inflicting me with some kind of effect that is annoying the shit out of me. Do I have anything I can throw at him? Let's throw some prism stones at him. I don't know. Maybe I can find a friend in this crazy world. We're gonna fight around these prism stones. Don't you dare come in for a fucking kill on that shrug, buddy. Alright. Now I'll fight him like a man, because he seems like kind of a cool guy. Ah, oh, the lag stab. Fair on his part. But of course, like, that latency is annoying when it happens to you. This guy's gonna kill me. He's a much stronger player than I am right now. And that's fine. You know, shit happens. Ooh. Maybe I can get lucky here. Ah, oh, the lag stab! God damn it! He's gonna bleed me out. Oh, you dick. But also, fair play. I could humanity up really quick. He's probably just gonna go in for the easy kill. Oh, I got a buddy on him. Alright, let's humanity up. You're gonna heal? No, I'm gonna heal. Alright, he's got aggro from the Silver Knight now, so he's gotta be a little bit more careful. That Silver Knight should follow him. Oh, come on! Oh, this is a cool invasion. I like this. Now, how am I going to get this guy killed? I'm going to try to run away. He's going to chase me into this room with the other Silver Knight. Maybe he's not going to follow me. He's had enough of my bullshit. He's over there? Okay, we'll fight on this hallway. This will be how it ends. Oh, don't spam sorceries. I'm not trying to be a dick to you. Okay, I'm going to try to get some backstabs on him, but it seems like he has a connection advantage. Again, no, you know, not his fault. He's doing well for himself. I like his character build. Oh, I thought that was going to poison me for sure. Or bleed me out, whatever. I like his character build. I think he's doing a good job. Seems like a cool guy. Yeah, he bled me. Oh, that's bad. That'll do it. Yeah, there we go. That was cool. Fair play to him. Usually I'll send a mess. Oh, don't be a dick. Always bow. Be honorable. How did your mother raise you? Well, he probably thinks I was a dick for just spamming humanity. Yeah, I know I'm going down, buddy. Congratulations. Usually I like to send them a message and say, like, good fight. But sometimes I get hate mail. Let's see what we got here. I don't know. Just an invitation to play Gears of War 3, which I don't own. So, Pimpizzle, if you're watching this, sorry, but I can't help you out there. We'll do one more invasion. This has been fun. And, you know, I'm psyched that I haven't probably had to do any editing, which feels good. So this has been a pretty standard setup of what PvP looks like. I haven't won as much as I would like to, which sucks. But we did get that early win on the guy who apparently just fell down a pit or maybe got killed by the mimic down where you get Havel's set. Not really sure what was going on there. I would love to show like one actual victory. That would feel good for me, so I could make you guys believe that I'm not just horrible at this game. But you know, the people who play Dark Souls, you have to be good at the game by this point, or at least decent at the game. That's the motherfucking guy right there. You know what? You're going down. You're going down. Oh, okay. Well, see you later. Yeah, you have to be competent at the game at this point. I mean, there's times when you invade people in Anor Londo and you know it's going to be an easy win from the start because they're still using like the Drake Sword, which is I didn't even pick up. It is definitely considered a noob weapon. Those words just don't feel natural coming out of my mouth. But when that happens, you know it's going to be an easy fight. Like, I can bow, they'll backstab me, it'll take off like 2% of my health. And you're just like, oh, okay, well, you have no chance. But you can still have fun with those. Let them heal. You know, spam pyromancy, but don't quite kill them. Let them get some practice in anyway. The thing I would love to say, my like take-home message about PvP, is I wish people weren't dicks to each other in PvP. Like, I wish invaders would invade fairly, not twink, and I wish hosts wouldn't be scared of PvP, but I think it's because of the twinking, at least partly, that invasions are so scary to twink, or invasions are so scary to people. So people will hide, people will like go back to the dashboard, which just kicks the invader out of the world, and then they reload their game, which is a dick move, especially if you're using cracked red-eye orbs, which actually cost 3,000 souls each. If you're worried about getting killed, just go hang out by the bonfire. When you get killed, you'll respawn with your humanity, like, or your humanity and souls, like, right there. No big deal. All right. Overhauls 69. You are going to be the ultimate, the end of this video. So let's make this a good fight. Please don't be a hacker, which happens occasionally. All right. It's kind of like a survival horror game at this part. I feel like it, like I'm a serial killer hunting them down, like cross-dimensional serial killer. So let's come up here and see. I'm guessing he's in here. There he is. Oh, no, that's the knight. And this is the other knight. Okay, we're going to hang out at the bottom here. Sometimes you got to play the waiting game. And if this guy is just hanging out, I can find him. Then I will actually let him kill these guys. Or we can go fight somewhere where he doesn't have to fight these guys. I mean, common tactic in PvP, draw them into enemies. But I can understand these guys are fairly difficult. He probably doesn't want to even come down if he's going to have to fight me around these guys. The problem is because so many invaders are dicks, it's difficult to let people know that you're not a dick. Mostly. I'm guessing he's up here. Nope. It's funny, there's actually a sorcery or a miracle which allows you to take on the form. I'm trying to watch where these guys are to figure out where he's at. Maybe at the blacksmith. That allows you to take on the form of like a, how would you say it? Like a background object, like a pot like this. So he could just be hiding right now. Which again, dick move. Eventually he's gonna have to fight me though. Maybe I will have to do a little bit of editing here as I look for him. And you know, I don't blame people for hiding. Again, I think invaders or hosts should win at all costs, essentially, because you have all the stakes. You can see right now, like, four invasions, no big deal for me. Like, if I die, I die. Just gonna check over here, because I can see this guy's moving. Or he was moving, I thought. Which would indicate, seemingly, that he's around here. But you know, I'm going to be a nice guy. I'm going to open up the shortcut here for him. So when he comes back through here, he'll be able to go through this faster and get to the blacksmith via that shortcut. And there's another shortcut I'll open up for him. Maybe that'll let him know that I'm actually kind of a nice guy. So I'll come up through here. Anytime you hear my couch move like that, just assume I'm touching the touchpad on my computer so it doesn't fall asleep. Come on, bro. Don't be a jerkwad. I just want to party. It's a multiplayer frenzy here. I just want to hang out on that railing. Looks like he might have already opened this door. Let's see. When people hide like this, it kind of pisses me off. You're wasting both our time, man. He's already opened this shortcut. I got a message from someone. It's hard to PvP and watch YouTube at the same time. Hey, Devonport97! I'm not sure if you're trash-talking me or if you actually know who I am, but if you do, that's cool, man. I like you. But I'm not going to message you back on camera because I have to use the on-screen keyboard and that would take 45 minutes. So, I'm going to send this guy a message, though. And basically be like, yo, bro, where you at? Send message, add text. I'm gonna type like a 9-year-old girl because I hate using this keyboard. Where are you, bro? And then 5 question marks. And maybe like one of these and a yen symbol as well. That's how you let him know that you're cool. That's a secret code. Probably shouldn't have recorded. Oh, you disc, motherfucker. Dude's an asshole. He basically went to the dashboard. Alright, well, he can suck on my nuts. This has been an example of how the PvP works in Dark Souls. I hope you guys enjoyed yourself with the video. I had a good time, had some good invasions, and, you know, a pretty accurate cross-section, I would say, of how invasions go. Some nice guys, some guys who are scared, which I can understand, but it's still kind of a dick move to just hide or go to the dashboard. Take your punishment like a man. Be abused and then go on to be an abuser. That's the natural cycle of Dark Souls. Just waiting to see if this guy sends me a message. I'll give it like another 10 seconds. The other covenant that is big for invading is called the Blades of the Dark Moon. They actually invade down. I bet that's the guy I was trying to find. They invade down, so they invade people who are lower level than them, but also people who have sinned, so people who have killed NPCs or betrayed their covenant. People like that. I haven't played as the Dark Moons, but apparently the invasions are less frequent, which is kind of a big reason why I go with the Dark Wraiths whenever I make a new character, because the opportunities for PvP are just so good. Anyway, this video was a lot of fun. It was a little different. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and you finally got a chance to see that my internet is not like 56k. It actually does work, even though I do get lag stabbed occasionally. As always, thank you guys for watching. I'm not sure what we're going to do in the next video. I'll probably go to like Great Hollow or Ash Lake. As always, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Did you send me a message? You didn't. What a jerk.